Hello everyone and welcome to this new lecture. In this lecture, we are going to cover data visualization. So let's get started. So in general, we are going to find there are four kind of very high level categories when we start to do visualizations. First, we have relationships. Second, we have comparisons. Third, we have distributions. And fourth, we have compositions. Again, pretty easy, pretty simple, straightforward stuff. I just wanted to cover it here, just in case you might see on the AWS Machine Learning Certification exam. So first, regarding relationships, kind of two important relationships in here. The first one is what we call a scatter plot. And scatter plot demonstrates the relationship between two variables, X and Y. Basically, I have here X, here I have Y. I can plot all the values here in a scatter plot format. I want to plot, for example, let's say temperature. And I can plot, let's say here on the y-axis, the ice cream sales, for example. Have a bunch of points, plot them here, call it a day, and that will show me the relationship between the independent variable x and the dependent variable y. That's all what it is. Another way of demonstrating relationships is what we call a bubble chart. Bubble chart demonstrates the relationship between three variables, x, y, and bubble size as well. So I can plot here the x on the x-axis, let's say a certain variable x. Here I can plot y. And in addition to that, now I have the size of the bubble. Okay, so now I can plot actually three variables together in one plot like that, using what we call the bubble chart. Okay, so again, that's another way of visualizing the relationships between variables. So now I have scatter plot and I have bubble plot, and these are kind of two belong to relationships. All right. The next one is comparison. So in comparisons, we have bar chart and we have line chart. So for bar chart, we can basically compare, let's say, employee salaries, for example. I can have employee 1, employee 2, 3, 4, and 5. And can by plotting that, then I would be able to compare the salaries of these different employees on a bar chart like that. However, here on the right-hand side, I can plot line chart. So I can compare median and average house prices over, let's say, the years, for example. So as you guys can see here, this is the median value. Let me zoom in. These are sales price in US dollars. Here we have the years. And by using the line chart, I can simply show the different, basically the variations of the house prices as over the years. And I can as well, by plotting two of them, I can compare the two as well on the same chart. So for example, as you guys can see, these are the house sales prices in US dollars in the US. So basically, like beforehand back then, you can buy a house for, let's say, you know, like 50K, for example, in 1975, in let's say the prime areas in US and even in Canada. However, right now in 2009, you know, you need like $300,000. So like basically the value of the dollar diminishes extensively. So I can read all that information from the line chart. And I can also compare, let's say, the median and the average between the two right away in one stop shop. And that's why line chart, let me go back, line chart and bar chart can be used for comparisons. All right, what about distributions? So I can also visualize the distributions. One example is histograms. So as you guys can see here, this is a histogram. So I can plot the histogram and I would be able to simply show the distribution of the data. I can know the mean and I can know the standard deviation as well, which indicates the dispersion from the mean. I can also use the box plot to basically show me the median value, to show me what we call it lower whisker and upper whisker. Think of it as the minimum and maximum values. And I can see the outliers as well. And because I know box plots might be a little bit confusing, that's why I decided to add specific slide for box plots. It's actually pretty straightforward. So for the box plots here, this basically line indicates the minimum value. This one indicates the maximum value. Here we have the median here. Here in this rectangle indicates the majority of the data. So 50% percentile will be here. And any data here indicates the outliers. These are the outliers that basically we highly likely we are going to remove it from the data because these screw up basically the machine learning algorithms. And we're gonna see how we're going to use a strategy or a technique called random cut forest to actually remove the outliers for us as well. All right, what about compositions? So we can also visualize data using compositions such as pie chart, stacked bar chart, and stacked area chart. For example, here I can show on one pie, I can show the compositions. For example, I can see, let's say, you know, like 31%, let's say, of the, for example, you know, of the Canadian population, for example, voted, let's say, liberals, 44 voted, let's say, conservatives, 19 with like NDP, something like that. So I can divide the Canadian, for example, population or the American population by using a pie chart, so I can see the composition as well. I can also use stacked bar chart like that. So basically I have over the years, I can stack here on top of each other, let's say broad, mixed, standard, so I can see different compositions within 1 year, for example, okay? I can also here see stacked area chart, so I can stack basically the different variables in here in an area fashion, basically. That's, as you guys can see here, different. I have a blue area or a blue zone, green zone, and yellow zone as well. All right, okay, that's all what I have for this lecture. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Again, please bear in mind that, again, I have relationships, such as scatter plot, bubble chart. I have comparisons, such as bar chart and line chart. I have distributions, such as histograms and box plots. And these are box plots, basically explanation. And here I have compositions, including pie chart, stacked bar chart, and stacked area chart as well. All right, in the next lecture, we are going to cover distributions. So we're going to learn about normal distribution. We're going to learn about standard normal distribution, Poisson distribution, binomial distribution. We're going to be tons of fun. Please stay tuned and please enjoy AWS Machine Learning Certification course. And I will see you guys in the next lecture.